Now we'll study angular acceleration. As far as the term acceleration is concerned, all of you are aware about it. Acceleration can be simply written as rate of change of velocity, which we already studied in detail about previous chapters. Now we are going to study about angular acceleration. Angular acceleration is a characteristic of angular motion like circular motion. Here it is defined as rate of change of angular velocity, which we have just defined in previous section. As far as acceleration is concerned, linear acceleration can be written as dv by dt, or it can also be written as v dv by dx. This we have covered in kinematics. In the same manner, when we talk about circular kinematics or angular kinematics, here these relations will transform in a different manner. Like angular acceleration is denoted by alpha. This is the letter alpha which is used to denote angular acceleration. We already studied that angular velocity is denoted by the term omega. So this relation A equals to dv by dt can be rewritten as alpha is equals to d omega by dt, or we can also define alpha as omega d omega by d theta. Like v dv by dx can be written as omega d omega by d theta, because here we are using displacement, here we'll use angular displacement. If you wish to approach to this result, you can multiply it by d theta upon d theta. So you can see this d theta by dt will become omega. So it will become omega d omega by d theta. The same thing can also be written as second derivative of angular displacement. It is d square theta by dt square. So these are the relations we use to define angular acceleration in terms of angular velocity, time and angular displacements. We can also develop a relation in linear acceleration with which the speed of particle changes in a circular motion. Say when a circle of radius r, a particle is moving with a speed v, or say velocity vector v. In this situation, if it has some acceleration because of which the speed is changing, we can very easily get it like here we know, we can write as we know, linear velocity can be written as r omega. If we differentiate this with respect to time, derivative of velocity will be dv by dt, r is a constant, it will become d omega by dt. Now dv by dt is the rate at which the speed of particle is changing, or this is the acceleration along the motion of particle. This can be written as linear acceleration, or more precisely we should write it tangential acceleration, because velocity is along the tangent of the circle. This will be equals to r into d omega by dt, we can write as alpha. This at we can write as tangential acceleration. All of you students, this tangential acceleration is a new term, but soon we are going to study about tangential acceleration in detail. We are calling it tangential acceleration because it is an acceleration acting along the velocity vector, or it is the acceleration because of which the speed of particle is changing and it is acting in the direction of tangent. That's why we call it tangential acceleration. Now we'll study the speed equations for constant angular acceleration. As we know, for linear motion, with constant acceleration, we use various speed equations like v is equals to u plus at. We use s is equals to ut plus half at square. We use v square as u square plus 2as. Similarly, displacement in nth second delta sn can be written as u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. These are the speed equation we use for constant acceleration in linear motion. Similarly, for uniform angular acceleration in circular motion, we use angular speed equations given as, these equations are written as omega is equals to omega naught plus alpha t. We use theta is omega naught t plus half alpha t square. Omega square is omega naught square plus 2 alpha theta. And delta theta n is equals to omega naught plus alpha by 2 into 2n minus 1. If you just have a look carefully on both the system of equations, you can see these are exactly analogous with these equations. Just some variables are replaced, which are representing linear motion here. Similar variables represent angular motion here. Like, here omega naught represent initial angular velocity and omega represent final angular velocity. Here alpha is the angular acceleration, theta is the angular displacement, and this delta theta n can be written as angular displacement in nth second. It is in the duration of nth second, and t we are using as time. So these are the angular speed equations which we can directly use in various problems wherever angular acceleration is uniform. If angular acceleration varies, we use the similar process of integration or differentiation like the one we have done in kinematics, in linear kinematics, whenever linear acceleration varies. In continuation, we can write, if in a case, angular acceleration is variable, then we use alpha is equals to d omega by dt, or we use alpha is equals to omega d omega by d theta. And simultaneously here omega is given as d theta by dt. These are the similar relations which we have studied in linear motion, which we use whenever linear acceleration is variable. Like we use a is equals to dv by dt, or we use a is equals to vd by dx, and we use velocity as dx by dt. These are the relations which we already use. Here in angular motion or circular motion, we are going to use these relations whenever angular acceleration varies. Like, for a simple example, we can say, if a body rotates such that its angular acceleration varies with time as alpha is equals to 4t cube plus 2t. Here we can see alpha is varying, and its unit we are given that radians per second square, and we are required to find angular speed of body at t equal to 2 seconds. If it starts from rest, it is also given that initially the body angular velocity was 0. Here we can very easily handle. It is obvious that angular acceleration depends on time. We cannot use angular speed equations. We need to use either of these relations. Like, here we write d omega by dt is equals to 4t cube plus 2t. This can be written as, rewritten as, d omega is 4t cube plus 2t into dt. Now we integrate this. It is given that at t equals to 0, angular speed was 0. we are required to find the angular speed when time is 2 seconds. If we just integrate it, left hand side is omega, right hand side on integration, it will become integration of t cube is t to the power 4 by 4. 4 gets cancelled out. Here integration of t is t square by 2. Here 2 gets cancelled out. So we'll be getting it t to the power 4 plus t square. And we put limits from 0 to 2. When you put the limits, the angular speed will be 16 plus 4, that is 20 radians per second. That is the answer to this question. This is the way how we are going to manage whenever angular acceleration varies with time. If it is a constant, we could have directly used the speed equations to get the results. We'll see some more examples on this.